How are you? So today I'm here to talk about a certificate which I have recently added to my bucket. So that certificate is AWS Certified Machine Learning Specialty. This is for the specialization of machine learning under AWS services. So I have recently pass that certification, and I'm getting a lot of requests through my YouTube channel and LinkedIn to explore or to share my knowledge or to share the roadmap which I have followed to get certified. So I'll be talking about that only today. First, this is the name of the certification which you can see on my screen, AWS Certified Machine Learning Specialty. This certification is to validate your ability so that you can build, train, tune, and deploy machine learning models using AWS Cloud. So this is going to be very beneficial to everyone who is going to try their hand for the machine learning under the AWS services. So this is the name of the certificate. So I'll be discussing about how to get yourself registered for that certification, what are the prerequisites that required before appearing for the certification, and apart from this, the learning material which I have followed and how much time I have invested for that certification. So guys, first let me tell you that I have spent 4 weeks, almost a month, to get certified. Apart from this, I'm into this data science or machine learning since so long. Apart from this, I train students during weekends for the data science machine learning using different languages like SAS, Python, and running my YouTube channel as well. So the knowledge which I'm transferring to the community is quite helpful for me, so that I am quite familiar with each and every part, because sometimes it happens that you are working for a particular project. Let's say it's related to the classification problem or then supervised learning. So you forgot about the regression part. So once you are into the training and you are delivering knowledge to somebody, so you are familiar, or you are in continuous touch with different topics altogether. So that's it. So that's my experience. That's why I'm sharing with you. So let's talk about the certification. First of all, you have to get yourself registered for AWS so that you can learn from there. AWS is providing a lot of material. You do not have to go anywhere to learn related to this part. They have given a very good stuff. Lot of videos are there, the digital training or the classroom session, virtual classroom sessions the people are providing. They do have a wonderful team for that. I must say I'm very thankful for them, because I haven't invested my time apart from the AWS training and the learning community. I was going through with their material only. So to register, you have to go to the aws.training and you have to sign in. You have to go there. If you do not have account, you can create your Amazon account. You simply click on this and you follow the instruction and you get yourself registered. So I have already registered, so I don't need to show you that part. You people can do that. In case of any confusion, you can feel free to write me. I'll help you with that. So now I'll be talking about the time and the questions and the fees for this certification. So the certification, these are the exam details which you can see on my screen. Format for the exam is multiple choice, multiple answers you have to give, and you have to choose the best suitable answer for that. Sometimes you see that all the options are quite related to that question, so it's quite confusing. It's very important to give some time to the questions so that you can clearly understand what actually they are looking for. Then this is for the specialization into the machine learning. This is the type of this particular exam, and the delivery method is for testing center or online exam. You can get it for the certification for both way, like you can get certified through online mode as well and through testing center. It's up to you how you want to go ahead. I have appeared online because due to this COVID-19, I couldn't get a chance to go through the testing center. And the time for completing this exam is almost 3 hours, 170 minutes. And the cost for the exam is $300. $300 you have to pay to give this particular exam. And they are also providing a practice exam set in case anybody want to go ahead the practice exam first. They simply get registered for that as well. You have to pay $40. And so that you can check that if you are prepared for the exam or not. I haven't go through with the practice exam. I went directly to the main exam for the $300 one. So they are also providing exam into different languages. It's up to you how you want to and which language you want to use. So this is about the exam. And in case you want to check the exam guide, they are also giving the exam guide. You can check that. This is here. This is the exam guide and everything related to the certification. And they have asked for the recommended AWS knowledge. Yes, it is required. A basic understanding of AWS, how to the ETL services, how to create buckets, the S3, Amazon S3, EC2 instances, Lambda function, and then the AWS cloud as well. And then they are looking for the ability to express the intuition behind basic ML algorithm, the experience performing basic hyperparameter optimization, which we people do while building machine learning models. They say that experience with ML and deep learning from frameworks required. I must say, yes, it is required. And the ability to follow model training best practice. Yes, it is also required. The ability to follow deployment and operational backs, the best services, right? And for the exam preparation, they have given a lot of training material. You can check that for the big data on AWS 3-day instructor led live courses. I haven't entered for any live classes. I was going through because the schedule were not matching to my preference. So I went through the white papers and other material which they have provided on the training page or training site. Other material like machine learning, Amazon machine learning concepts, splitting your data, types of machine learning models, data transformation, containerized machine learning on AWS, videos are available for that. Reinvent machine learning talks. These are videos were quite helpful. And for the exam content, you can see multiple choice, multiple response, and there's no negative marking. And the passing score for this exam is 750. You should score at least 75% to get pass. So this you have to keep in mind this part. And they have combined this exam in four particular domain, and they have distributed the whole exam into these domains, like 20% related to the data engineering, 24% for the exploratory data analysis, 36 for the model building, and 20% for machine learning implementation and operation, which is around the AWS services. So they have also given you the subdomains under these domain, data engineering, exploratory data analysis, modeling. So you have to go through with this topic. That is really important. And then I must show you the sample questions. I mean, you will be getting the scenario-based question. You can see that these are the sample questions which you have provided. You can check that. These are the sample questions. So you have to go through with that. You really have to focus on the question. You can, might be sometime it happens like you feel like all answers are best suited for that question. So just to get that understanding, first you have to go through with the question. It's really important and it would be quite helpful while you will be appearing for the exam. Fine. Now let me show you the path or the roadmap. This is the machine learning path or data scientist path. I have followed this one. The very good stuff is there. the element of data science. This is 8 hours video training the people have provided. This is very helpful. Data science capstone real world ML decision. This is also the one of the important module. Machine learning data readiness, how you prepare your data before building a model. This is also important. Developing machine learning applications, in what situation, in what scenario, what algorithm is best suited, that you have to understand. And they have given very good stuff for that part as well, so that you can go through with this as well. And the practical data science with Amazon SageMaker. See, this certification is more around Amazon SageMaker. This is a custom tool which help you to train, build, tune, deploy model on AWS cloud. So this is really an important topic. Then machine learning pipeline on AWS. And they have given one other module, which is machine learning security. And this module, exam readiness, AWS certified machine learning specialty. This is the module which is quite similar to the exam which you are going to appear. They have given each and every topic or the subtopic covered under this particular module. And you have to invest 4.5 hours to go through with this part. And some optional module as well, good to have that knowledge. Math for machine learning, for all the maths behind machine learning algorithms, linear and logistic regression, mostly use algorithms. Speaking of machine learning and NLP, it's more about the translation or the natural language programming, seeing clearly computer vision for the recognition, maze recognition videos, and for the computer vision part. So you have to go through with this. I have all the data prepared. I'll be sharing with you guys all the material. And then I'm giving you what I have completed. This is the part. See, once you go through with any of the module, so they are giving some quiz. You go through with that part and you solve those quiz. It's very helpful and it would help you to get yourself prepared for the exam. So I must say that please solve those quiz. Very helpful for you. And come while you will be moving ahead with all the training material, you get the completion certificates as well. So you can see my screen. These are my completion certificates which I have achieved. I have started on 27th of April and I got certified on 23rd of May. So you can see I have started this part on 22nd of April. And it takes 1 or 2 days to get myself prepared what and where I have to learn. So I have go through with that part and then I started exploring. And these are the completion certificate which I have completed. And you guys also follow the same path so you can get this completion certificate. How this completion certificate looks like, let me show you one of them. You simply click on this and this is the completion certificate. And you see how much hours you spend and what day you complete that. Very helpful. I must say you guys go through with that part. Interesting as well. You will be learning a lot of things. And then this is the part. And then I say that you go through with this part. Amazon SageMaker. This is one of the most important part for this. You will be getting almost 8 to 10 questions related to Amazon SageMaker. 8 to 12 I say. So those were around Amazon SageMaker only. It is really important to go through with this part. You cannot ignore this. I have each and everything for that part as well. And then for the AWS AI services. These are the pre-built services of AWS, which you have to understand. You will be getting questions related to these two. Might be, you say, 8 to 10 questions related to the AWS AI services, where we have, they'll be giving you a certain scenario and you have to give them the, select the best option at what AI services you will be using for that particular situation. Very important topic, I must say. So this is also there. You can go through with this part. And then that's it that you have to follow. And for the AWS cloud, I say if anybody do have a practitioner level knowledge, that is good to have. In case you do not have, you spend 4 to 5 days to go through with that part. and you would be good to go, would be in a good to go situation. They are also given a very good stuff. I have gone through with that part only. And then that's it. And now I'm going to show you my certificates, what I received, and my scorecard. So see, this is the scorecard which I have received just for the 1 month preparation. I got 881 out of 1000. Not so bad. So, but the passing marks was 750, which I said 75% required to get certified for this one. Once you're done with the exam, you get pass and fail on your screen, and then after, within 5 working days, you will get your scorecard on your registered email address and your certification on your AWS account. You can simply download from there. It would be a PDF. And here is my certification. Isn't it look good? So this is the certification and the name and the certification and issuing date. And these are the validation number. You can simply validate from there. So this is valid for 3 years, guys. And you, if you spend some time learning this, so it is really helpful, I must say. You will be getting some hands-on knowledge for machine learning using AWS. And interesting as well. Now I must say, these are the information which is apart from this. I'll be coming with a different video where I'll show you how to get registered for the exam. This is for the learning part, and for the certification, we should have a different registration. I'll show you how to do that. So that's it, guys. I have prepared each and everything. I'll be sharing with you through email. I say that you please drop down your email into the comment box. I'll be sharing you the whole content, the whole dumps which I have prepared for you and prepared for myself. I'll be sharing with you, and I would be really happy to see that some people can also get certified using all those stuffs. So fine, guys, happy learning, and feel free to connect me. Share your email address so that I can share stuff with you. Please, you can drop me email, you can drop me comment or a message anytime related to this. I would be happy to help you guys. Fine, guys, must say best of luck for the preparation, and good luck to get certified. Thank you, guys.